What was the difference between tonight and that game and the fish tank?
I think a lot of his confidence earlier in the year that we talked about. We just had a hard time finishing games. You know, we were either winning big games or we were losing by small margins. And a lot of it was just coming down to execution, confidence at the end, ball control, knowing the situations of the game. And we've put a few more of those situations in practice. And I think the guys, you know, once you get a couple of wins in those close games, it just, you know, also breeds confidence. And all of a sudden your habits are falling onto good habits instead of bad habits. So it also helped out. Last game, I don't think we had Will. We had Nathan. So just getting two bigs back, we were able to put both of them at the same time. And we matched up a little bit differently with Lynch. Last time we had a big play, big on big. And this time we played him with guards the entire time, as he is a three-point shooter. And then we tried to jump Eustein. Obviously, he's trying to get to the rack. He's very good at distributing the ball. Basically, anytime he was driving into the lane or off the elbow, we were jumping into the other end. So just a couple sporadic things that changed for this game.
And obviously, unofficial stance, but you mentioned Tristan Lynch. He'd switch it up from a big to a guard to cover him. Four free throws. That was all he made tonight. No field goals. How happy are you with the defensive play on, you know, a top three player in the conference?
Yeah, I mean, I believe right now he's averaging like 24 points a game to hold him to a 7-4. I didn't realize it was that low, but I could tell, you know, you were joking around before the game. I said, we'll put Baylor on him because he's the strongest man in the locker room. I know you can body him up. Got a good lap out of the guys. And, at the same time, you know, has confidence too, like everybody in our conference. So, you know, he was up for the challenge and did it last night, and hit him on our best player last night in the same time. So, really happy with our defensive effort. Seeing, you know, just the easy buckets in transition, and the guys are obviously getting good looks from the outside as well.
What was your message to your team after this one? Obviously, you got to be thrilled with this game. I'm sure what you told them at halftime didn't really change much from what you told them at halftime for much of the season. But what was that victory speech like?
Yeah, we didn't really have much of a victory speech. To be honest, we kind of just jumped around and yelled. It was the guys that were pretty chaotic and they were excited. You know, there's a lot of highs and a lot of lows throughout the season. And we tried to just enjoy each moment. So we got a locker room and there was, you know, brief, you know, calls from captains and other coaches and some yelling, some things like that, and it's a chance. And gave a brief message. I don't even remember what I said, but we've got to practice tomorrow. We come back Monday, Tuesday, so we've got a busy and complete Thursday, so busy schedule this week.
Well, we'll see you on Monday against Oconto. Congratulations, coach. We'll see you then, and congrats on the big victory.
Thank you. Thanks for being here. Thank you to our sponsors as well.
And we'll give them a quick little shout out as well. Gentlemen, Sharon.